Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome back to the channel. We are going to cover the fourth and final chapter of Ruth. And I just want to say before we get started that I woke up this morning with such joy in my heart. This weekend has been amazing so far. And nothing, you know, out of the ordinary has happened. But during this series, I've just really felt the presence of the Lord. And I hope that you have too. And anytime that we spend time in His Word is a time that we gain wisdom, and, you know, just feeling His presence is always a blessing. I hope that wherever you are on this globe, that you are just surrounded by love and with just the biggest smile on your face and sunshine and just grace, the grace of our Lord Jesus. I'm telling you, this morning was just amazing because I'm realizing that, as Esther said, you know, perhaps we were placed on this earth for such a time as this in the book of Esther, right? So Mordecai was saying that to his niece, Queen Esther. And I feel like that's so true. Each and every one of us was placed on this earth for a purpose, for the Lord's purpose. And I truly believe that part of my purpose is doing what I'm doing right now, is reading the Word, praying over this channel, you know, reaching out to whoever the Lord brings my way to continuously be salt and light and a representation of Him. I don't always get it perfect. Please don't get me wrong. I make tons of mistakes all the time. But when I do make those mistakes, you know, we have His grace and His mercy. You know, the scripture that says, morning by morning, new mercies I see. I need every single one of those mercies. And I'm so grateful for them. But I'm really grateful for YouTube and for the internet, because I feel like this moment in time is such a blessing, because it wasn't available not too long ago, you know. And with new technology and the advancement in technology, we grow closer, we grow more interconnected. And that's what it's all about, brothers and sisters, you know, fellowship with one another, even on a virtual level. And so I just want to say I'm grateful for each and every one of you, past, present, and future subscribers. I'm grateful for the Word of God. I'm grateful for Him waking me up this morning in my right mind and with such joy in my heart. So with that being said, I'm going to, as always, open with prayer and ask that the Lord opens our hearts to His Word, that we may glean the wisdom that He has for us from the scriptures, and send you all off with a blessing at the end of the chapter. And as always, you know, please feel free to leave a comment. I would love if you could give me a like. It definitely will help the channel, and a subscription. That would be great, because I definitely want to hear from all of you. With that being said, let's get into prayer and then into His Word. Heavenly Father, we thank You so much, Lord God, for all of Your blessings. We thank You, Lord, for this series. Every single chapter in Your Word is full of love and wisdom. And as we finish the book of Ruth, we just ask, Lord, that You would have it multiply and be bountiful within our hearts and in our minds and in our spirits, Lord. And we just thank You and we praise You for Your Word. We just ask, Lord, that You would just send Your angels to protect and guide and encourage each and every person, Lord God. And we just thank You for all of Your blessings, past, present, and future. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's get into it. The Book of Ruth, chapter 4. Meanwhile, Boaz went up to the town gate and sat down there just as the guardian redeemer he had mentioned came along. Boaz said, "Come over here, my friend, and sit down." So he went over and sat down. Boaz took 10 of the elders of the town and said, "Sit here," and they did so. Then he said to the guardian redeemer, Naomi, who has come back from Moab, is selling a piece of land that belonged to our relative, Elimelech. I thought I should bring the matter to your attention and suggest that you buy it in the presence of these seated here and in the presence of the elders of my people. If you will redeem it, do so. But if you will not, tell me so I will know. For no one has the right to do it except you, and I am next in line. I will redeem it, he said. Then Boaz said, on the day you buy the land from Naomi, you also acquire Ruth the Moabite, the dead man's widow, in order to maintain the name of the deed of the dead with his property. At this, the guardian redeemer said, then I cannot redeem it, because I might endanger my own estate. You redeem it yourself. I cannot do it. Now, in earlier times in Israel, for the redemption and transfer of property to become final, one party took off his sandal and gave it to the other. This was the method of legalizing transactions in Israel. So the guardian redeemer said to Boaz, buy it yourself. And he removed his sandal. Then Boaz announced to the elders and all the people, today you are witnesses that I have bought from Naomi all the property of Elimelech, Chilion, and Mahlon. I have also acquired Ruth, the Moabite, Mahlon's widow, as my wife, in order to maintain the name of the dead with his property, so that his name will not disappear from among his family or from his hometown. Today, you are witnesses. Then the elders and all the people at the gates said, we are witnesses. May the Lord make the woman who is coming into your home like Rachel and Leah, who together built up the family of Israel. May you have standing Ephrah, and be famous in Bethlehem. Through the offspring the Lord gives you by this young woman, may your family be like that of Perez, whom Tamar bore to Judah. I apologize for messing up that name, you guys. If you know how to pronounce it, please let me know in the comments. So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife. When he made love to her, the Lord enabled her to conceive, and she gave birth to a son. The women said to Naomi, praise be to the Lord, who this day has not left you without a guardian redeemer. May he become famous throughout Israel. He will renew your life and sustain you in your old age. For your daughter-in-law, who loves you and who is better to you than seven sons, has given him birth. Then Naomi took the child in her arms and cared for him. The women living there said, Naomi has a son, and they named him Obed. He was the father of Jesse, the father of David. Then this is the family line of Perez. Perez was the father of Hezron. Hezron the father of Ram. Ram the father of Amminadab. Amminadab the father of Nashon, Nashon the father of Salmon, Salmon the father of Boaz, Boaz the father of Obed, Obed the father of Jesse, and Jesse the father of David. Amen. Bless the reading of his word. So I love the fact that they always include the lineage, just because we can see how Ruth became a part of the lineage of Christ, right? As well as King David. And just through her obedience, she blessed not only her mother-in-law, but everyone in the town. Praise be to God. With that being said, brothers and sisters, many blessings to you. I pray that you have a wonderful weekend, and let this word be a blessing and encouragement, and let the Lord open his floodgates of wisdom and sanctification for each and every one of you. As always, if you guys have any prayer requests, please leave them in the comments. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel, and I will talk with all of you later. Take care. Bye.